are very blessed to have the offerings of His Holiness Bhakti Purushottam Swami. His Holiness Bhakti Purushottam Swami Maharaj is a disciple of His Holiness Srila Jayapataka Swami Maharaj. He is based here in Mayapur. He is a very, very active, adventurous, intelligent genius in preaching. Many of the things which we see here in Mayapur blossoming, like the festivals, the Mayapur International School, he has recently started to pen down his realizations, and what wonderful books have flowed: Radharani, Damodar, about death, about Maya Devi. We hope to have his books also after some time. Those who are interested can buy it. Maharaj is very active internationally. He's a GBC for many areas. He travels to the Middle East, to Europe regularly. So we would like to welcome Maharaj first of all by loudly chanting three times. Hari Bo.
Namah Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swamineti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschata Desatarine. So I prefer to come and speak here. I was in Samadhi. There are so many speakers. So before the speaker pick up the microphone, they are about to stop him. Oh, there is no time. So, but at the same time, I don't have things to speak about Srila Prabhupada, so much things, because I have personally not, I did not have personal association with Srila Prabhupada. To speak much to you, I'll just spend few minutes, and then Srila Sivaram Swami Maharaj will be here, and you can hear many nice things from Maharaj. So the point is, I am sure the most of here present, you have not seen Prabhupada. Most or everybody? Any Prabhupada disciples here? No, they're all there. So all of us, we have not seen Prabhupada. But we can see Prabhupada. How can we see Prabhupada? Prabhupada said, the ISKCON is my body. So ISKCON is not different from Prabhupada. So we can see Prabhupada through his disciples that he has left in this planet for us to associate. Through his society, we can see Prabhupada. So a tree, how can we understand a tree? There is a saying in Sanskrit, Vriksha phalena parichayate. The tree can be tested by its fruits. And we can see, we can test Prabhupada's greatness through his fruits that he has left in this planet, his great disciples who are leading us so able way. So that is the glories of Srila Prabhupada. So Srila Prabhupada, he told that, he told to his followers that I have developed the society. Prabhupada created this society, this great family, international family, and he brought it to certain level. But Prabhupada was always apprehensive that what will happen after I leave, how these people will manage this society. So at one point Prabhupada said that whatever I am giving you, at least to maintain it. That was Prabhupada's expectation. That whatever I have given you, at least maintain it. If that would happen, Prabhupada would be very happy. But here we see in Mayapur, that what Prabhupada gave by his mercy and Mayapur, we see so much things has happened. The day Prabhupada left planet, what was Mayapur and what it is today, it's a big difference. But one thing we should understand, whole world, Prabhupada's instruction for whole world is something, but Prabhupada's instruction for Mayapur is different. For whole world, Prabhupada said that what I have given you, you maintain. But for Mayapur, Prabhupada did not say what I have given you, maintain it. Prabhupada told that I am giving you the kingdom of God. He told to Srila Jayapataka Maharaj that I am giving you kingdom of God and you develop it. The point I am trying to say, if Prabhupada says something, things happens according to his desire, according to his words. Prabhupada has desire that a Vedic city will manifest here. And Prabhupada's desire also supported by Lord Nityananda Prabhu's desire. Ek adbhut mandir haibe prakash, gaurangar nityalila haibe vikas. So whatever is happening in our society, that is happening by the desire of Srila Prabhupada and previous acharyas. And we are simply making ourselves very fortunate by being part of this movement. Movement is not getting benefits from us, but we are getting benefit from movement. So Srila Prabhupada, so he gave us this wonderful family as the astrologer had predicted when he was a small baby. But this boy, he has a potency, he will create a family where whole world can live. And that is what we see in Mayapur. We have devotees from more than 50 countries and 70 gurus, disciples. They stayed together in the Siddha Mayapur to serve Srila Prabhupada. So in this way, that we have to be very careful to make ourselves very fortunate to stay in line by the instruction of Srila Prabhupada. And Srila Prabhupada, that he came to this material world, and whatever has happened, that he now the holy name has spread all over the world. All these things did not happen accidentally. Prabhupada has not come to this earthly planet, and whatever has happened, it has not happened accidentally. It is a very well planned since long time. The desire, what I am saying, not desire of Srila Prabhupada, not only desire of previous acharyas, the desire of Krishna. Thousands of years ago, what has been predicted? 5,000 years ago, when Krishna is about to leave this planet, all holy rivers personification, they came to Lord Krishna. Oh Lord, you are leaving. We will not stay, we will go back to spiritual world. Because all these holy rivers, Ganga, Jamuna, Saraswati, they are not from this material world. In Purana describes how they manifested, appeared in Golok Vrindavan, then come to Vaikuntha, then heavenly planets, then Martyaloka, then Patalaloka. They all come from spiritual world. They said that we will all go back. The Purana says, Kali Yuga passed 5,000 years, all Grama Devata puja will stop. Grama Devata means many of you must have come from village. Every village, Shiva temple, Kali temple, many temples. But now, 5,000 passed, it is predicted all this puja will stop gradually. That is happening. And 10,000 years, Kali Yuga pass, all holy rivers will dry up, go back to Godhead. So anyway, when this holy rivers came to Krishna, said, I will go back because Kali Yuga is coming. People bathe in your water, they leave all their sin into your water. How can you tolerate that? Lord Krishna said, no, you stay here. 5,000 years from now, after 5,000 years, the time will come that whole world will be ek varna. All will become one varna, one. They'll become Vaishnav. And then Krishna said that they will come from whole world to India and they will take bath in your water, chanting Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. And Krishna said, with their association, your water will be purified. You will spend time with them very happily. And now we see thousands of Vaishnavas coming from all over the world to take bath in holy rivers like Ganga, Jamuna, Saraswati, Kaveri. And who made it possible? Srila Prabhupada made it possible. What answer will people have for this prediction of Krishna? Vivekananda made it possible. Aurobindo made it possible. Who made it possible? Srila Prabhupada made it possible. Very simple. It's 5,000 years ago. In Padma Puran, it has been described when Bhakti Devi, Narad Muni, after traveling different parts of India and Kali Yuga started, came to Vrindavan. There he could hear somebody crying. And following that crying, he went on the bank of Yamuna. Narad Muni saw very beautiful Devi sitting, surrounded by many other ladies. She's crying, others are counseling her. Then two old people lying on her lap or in front of her, very skinny, sleeping, their white hair. Then Narad Muni was approaching. So that Devi got up, came forward and offered obeisances to Narad Muni. Then Narad Muni asked, hey, who are you? You're sitting here in this forest. Who are all these ladies surrounding you? And who are these two old people? Then she said that I am Bhakti Devi. And these ladies surrounding me, they're counseling, they're all the reverse personification. And the two old people lying there, they're my son, Jnana and Vairagya. I took birth in Dravida Desh. Then I came to Maharashtra. I was very healthy. Who are from Maharashtra? So Bhakti Devi said, she was very healthy. Then she said, but when I came to Gujarat, I became very weak. I don't know why. Anybody from Gujarat? I know Gujarat people are all Krishna Bhakta. But some of the Purana said, she said, when I came to Gujarat, I became very weak. No? Then finally I came to Vrindavan. But when I came to Vrindavan, I became very young. But my two sons, Jnana Vairagya, they are not coming back to senses. They are lying here old because Jnana Vairagya has no place in Vrindavan. Bhakti will flourish. Jnana Vairagya cannot flourish in Vrindavan. Then in that conversation, she mentioned one thing. She told Narad Muni that I will leave Vrindavan and go to foreign countries. Vrindavan paritejya videsham gamyate maya. Videsham means foreign countries. So that she told, I'll leave Vrindavan, go to foreign countries. Who brought Bhakti Devi to foreign countries? Who else except Srila Prabhupada? And that Prabhupada, who is carrying Bhakti Devi within his heart. Bhakti Devi saying, no, the Shastra says, Bhakti Bhagavat Bhakta Sangana Parijayate, Bhakti Devi is residing within the heart of the Bhaktas. That is the unique thing in getting Bhakti. That by practicing we cannot get bhakti because bhakti has to be transformed. The pure devotees carrying bhakti within their heart, it has been transformed from their heart to our heart. By some mechanical process, by some exercise, you cannot get bhakti, it has to come from there. So that is what happened. Before Prabhupada go to America, there are so many translations of Bhagavad Gita, but nobody has become devotee of Krishna. But only when Prabhupada carried Bhakti Devi within his heart, that he, Prabhupada has two heart attacks. How that heart can be attacked? Where Bhakti Devi is sitting, what that attack can do? Of course, very obvious. And then it is confirmed that Prabhupada carried Bhakti Devi from Vrindavan. That's predicted. Bhakti Devi told herself to Narada Muni that I'll leave Vrindavan, I'll go to foreign countries. And through Prabhupada's heart, when she was carried to America, then we saw the good results. What happened? How America, big revolution, devotional revolution, spreading all over the world. It is 5,000 years ago. Planned, this is planned, well planned, not accidental. 500 years ago, Mahaprabhu also predicted that Mahaprabhu preached all over India. Then Mahaprabhu predicted, my Senapati Bhakta will come. And he will be Prithivete Achyata Nagaradigram Sarvatra Pracharite Haive Moranam. Mahaprabhu predicted, my Senapati Bhakta will come. So now whole world now chanting with the holy name. Who made it possible? Who can take credit for this? 500th anniversary of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, whole India is glorifying Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. I was temple president in Bhubaneswar that time. In Orissa, Bengal, so much news articles comes, different societies they're celebrating. But one interesting thing, whatever articles they make for Mahaprabhu, at the end they must mention Prabhupada's name. But without Prabhupada's achievement, Mahaprabhu's achievement is not really revealed to people. So they have to say how Prabhupada is the only one who made Mahaprabhu's prediction, made it possible, translated into reality. That Mahaprabhu has predicted, my Senapati Bhakta will come. So who is Senapati Bhakta? That is Srila Prabhupada. 500 years ago. 5,000 years ago, prediction. 500 years ago, prediction. Then 150 years ago prediction, 150 or 200 years, 250 maybe. Bhaktivinoda Thakur came. What he predicted? Aha, when that day will come, that people from Russia, Persia, Russia means Russia, Persia means France, they will come to India, they will embrace the Indian devotees, Arya Santan. And together they'll chant, Jai Sachinandana, Jai Sachinandana, Jai Sachinandana. That was predicted, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. But when it manifested to reality, only when Srila Prabhupada went to America, established the ISKCON Society, then from all over the world, these Russians, France people, they all came. And now we see, as I said, in Mayapur, you have more than 50 country people sitting together, sleeping together, eating together, hearing together, chanting together, dancing together. This 250 years ago prediction, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Then Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada came, who really established this Navadvip Dham, following the footsteps of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. He also predicted that how people will come from all over the world, and especially they will do Navadvip Dham Parikrama. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada said, you want to serve Mayapur? Three ways to serve Mayapur. Through book printing, Namahatta preaching, and developing Navadvip Parikrama. So now we see how how throughout the year people are coming to Mayapur. We started Mayapur Navadvip Parikrama with 250 people, increasing, 10,000 devotees walking during Navadvip Mandal Parikrama Gaur Purnima time, walking from island to island, sleeping in different island, discussing Gaurakatha. And third year, different yatra coming, like this yatra also. This was predicted by Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada. The point I'm trying to make, this is not accidental what has happened. How it is well planned all the way since 5,000 years ago. This is an ordinary thing. So then about Srila Prabhupada, Prabhupada went to America. So one thing we have to observe. Now also many people going to America. Not people like Mayavadis, Sunnavadis, many Vaishnavs also going to America. But whoever goes to America now, from Gaudiya Math, from ISKCON, many people are going. But whoever goes to America, but Srila Prabhupada will remain as the Acharya for next 10,000 years. Nobody can become equal to Srila Prabhupada. In which sense? We can see there are people going to America, different parts of the world. They are getting big audience. 50,000, 100,000 people hearing them. Prabhupada time, not so many people are coming to hear Prabhupada. So in one sense, these people are doing so great. There are people, they are speaking so high philosophy, all kinds of things about Krishna, which Prabhupada might not have spoken to people. But in one sense, we see, now people are going to Western countries, they are doing so great. But in spite of that, Prabhupada will remain as unique. In which sense, my understanding is, people may speak big, big things, big philosophy, they may get big audience, but what Prabhupada has done to American people, no other preachers like us, we are going, we have to do to American people, we don't have to do. What Prabhupada has done? What Prabhupada has done? Prabhupada has taught them how to wear dhoti, wearing sari, how to take a bath, what not. Any other preacher going, they have to do like this? What is Prabhupada's unique contribution? His unique contribution is when he went, nobody was there to receive him. It is a unique contribution. And when we go, everything, send the email, car is ready, reception is ready, everything is there. Big, big preachers are going. So that is the unique things that nobody has to do for next 10,000 years. What Prabhupada has done for the world. Not only the philosophy, Prabhupada's caring mood, Prabhupada's tolerance. What Prabhupada has tolerated, now preachers, they don't have to tolerate that. What Prabhupada has tolerated? You must have heard how Prabhupada went and was thinking, planning to make one person disciple. Then one day sitting, writing, and that person came drinking wine with red eyes to attack Prabhupada. And Prabhupada ran away from there on the street, doesn't know where to go, what to do. Will any other big, big preachers have to face the situation in America? No. At the end, I will tell you something, what Prabhupada has gone through, what kind of people he had to deal with. I have heard that time ISKCON was not so opulent. They would stay in one room, brahmachari, one side they put a sari or kapada, cloth, one side brahmachari and one side brahmacharini. Very less facilities. We have heard when Mayapura started, how they're going through trouble. And one place, there is one toilet to use. and all devotees standing in line. Prabhupada came standing in line also. People that didn't have that much knowledge to say, Swamiji, please go ahead. Prabhupada has to tolerate that. Who will tolerate like that? I had once, so I read maybe some books, Prabhupada Nectar, Mukunda Maharaj, he was driving Srila Prabhupada. Then Prabhupada bite one apple and gave to Mukunda Maharaj. And Mukunda Maharaj bite and gave him to Srila Prabhupada. Now it is very funny to hear, for us we are laughing. But imagine someone will do to me like this. How I'll feel, no? This person behaved. What kind of people Prabhupada dealt with? My point is, why Prabhupada is Acharya? He is not Acharya, he spoke big, big philosophy, big, big, all esoteric pastimes of Radha and Krishna. But what he did for the people in the world, Western world, no other people, they have to do like this. That is importance. That is unique position of Srila Prabhupada. Now India, whole India is very proud of their great personalities. Somebody went from India, from Bengal specifically, and gave a big lecture in Chicago. Who is that personality? Huh? Everybody knows, Vivekananda. He's a great personality. We should not blame him. He's a great personality. And Indians are proud. He first brought our Indian culture to America because he gave a lecture. But point is, how many people, by reading those Bhagavad Gita, hearing his lecture, how many people's life have changed? He brought only one lady. You may not know her name, but all Bengalis, they know her name. You know her name? Huh? What is her name? What is her name? One lady, Vivekananda brought from America. Her name is Nivedita. You know, Bengalis are very proud of Nivedita. Vivekananda brought Nivedita, American lady. He converted to Hindu. I tell to the Bengalis, but one lady he brought, you are so proud of Vivekananda. But how many lady Prabhupada brought from America? Huh? Are you proud of Prabhupada like that? Are Indians proud of Prabhupada like that? Why Indians are not opening their eyes to see Prabhupada? Prabhupada has contributed for India. How many people are wearing sari? In other missions, they have brought people from Western countries. What Prabhupada has contributed? But only one problem. Why people, they don't know? One problem is, unlike other society founders, Ramakrishna, Ravi Shankar, so many societies, no? Aravinda. No? You see, they're all pushing themselves to be known. Society name by their own name. But Prabhupada, being real Vaishnav, he did not broadcasted himself. He kept him very humble. So now as a result, whole world knows Hare Krishna, but nobody knows Prabhupada. Yes or no? Huh? Yes? Hardly people know Prabhupada. You go walk in New York, oh, Hare Krishna going, Hare Krishna going. You know, they'll say, these are Hare Krishna people. Prabhupada tricked in such a way that everybody's mouth, Hare Krishna will come. Right? Not Vivekananda, not like that. That is Prabhupada. That is Prabhupada. He made a system like that. But now it is our duty to make whole world to know about Srila Prabhupada. Yes. It's now our responsibility. It's our responsibility for next 10,000 years. And if people will know, specifically Indians, they know Srila Prabhupada, then our preaching will 100 times increase just by knowing. Indians, they know Krishna. Many, they know Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, but they don't know Prabhupada. When they know Prabhupada, our preaching will flourish more and more. So we are very proud and we are very happy that so many devotees, Srila Radhanath Swami Maharaj, bringing in every 2-3 years to Mayapur Dham. Actually, Mayapur, it is a house for everybody. And everybody, you are delegated your service in different parts of the world. You take Mayapur as your house. Whatever difficulties you have faced here, please excuse us due to inability, and we are trying our best to facilitate it. And whenever you all come, so we all Mayapur leaders come here just to get association of Srila Radhanath Maharaj and all of you. Because as I said, the Prabhupada greatness manifests through all of you. How great he is, that depends on how great his followers are. So I would like to thank all of you. Jai Srila Prabhupada ki, Samvet Bhakta Vrinda ki, Gaura Premanande. Now, as I told you, I don't have much experience with Srila Prabhupada, direct experience. I don't have much to speak. I just passing time until Maharaj come. So now His Holiness Sivaram Maharaj Swami is here. You will directly hear from His lotus mouth His experience with Prabhupada. What He has experienced, the greatness about Prabhupada, to make our life successful, we'll hear to His Holiness Sivaram Swami Maharaj. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Bhakti Pacharam Tomi Maharaj.